guys, welcome back to Life, Food, and Johnson's. Today we are cooking one of my favorites, pepper steak.
Okay, well, this is what I have here. A lot of folks call me and they say, all right, hey, could you make me some pepper steak? So I'm going to show you how simple it is to make pepper steak. Anybody can
do it. Yeah, you don't have to go to a Chinese restaurant.
That's right, you don't have to go to a Chinese restaurant. You can just make it yourself. It's real simple. All you have to do is cut you some peppers, green peppers. You can use red if you want red peppers. Cut you a bunch of onions, about a couple onions, 2 pounds of steak. I have over here, you have to have a little roux because you got to thicken the gravy up a little bit. Then we have soy sauce right here, about half a cup, teaspoon. I use Montreal seasoning, steak seasoning, because it gives a light little flavor. And I got, you know, regular black pepper here. And I got 2 cups of beef base that we're going to put in there too. But actually, we're going to need more than 2 cups of beef base. But for right now, we're going with that. Okay, what you want to do?
If you got a wok.
If you don't have a wok, you can still do it. You can do it with a skillet, whatever. But I just been fortunate enough to have a wok.
Yeah.
Okay, what you want to do, you want to add a little oil, because you have to add a little oil because you don't want to burn your stuff. Okay, what I'm doing, so this is already getting hot. As you can see, I already got my rice done already. You know, I don't have to explain to you anyone how to make rice. It's real simple. You can use success rice or you can boil your own rice. Depends on what you want to do. Okay, so what I'm doing, I'm going to add my peppers. Yeah, as you can see, the grease is very hot, so that's what you want, okay?
You're gonna add your green and red pepper.
Add your green and red pepper, okay? So you hear that? That's the sign of success. Okay. Just gonna stir it up a little bit. Okay. Yeah.
And do you want your peppers cut big or nice?
Well, it depends on you. You can cut the peppers however you like. You can cut them small, large. Depends on how you like it. I like mine a little large.
Me too.
And onions. Okay, you just know there you go, assistant. Okay.
The cool thing is, I normally just use green peppers and he uses red peppers. So you can use red or green peppers.
Yeah, but I use both because to me, I like the sweetness of the red and I like the color of the green. So the original way most people make their pepper steak, they use green peppers, okay, just all green. But I mean, if you feel like you want to put some yellow pepper, red pepper, green pepper, orange pepper, just go right ahead, and it's fine. So whatever suits you. And as you can see, you got to make sure your vegetable is cooked very well. So I'm gonna add steak on there. So you know what I'm doing?
What you gonna do?
Matter of fact, honey, if you can't have another pan,
like the saute pan.
Yeah, saute pan, whatever. Okay. And like I say, pepper steak is a very easy dish. You can actually make this, like I said, this dish will be done in 15 minutes or less. Okay? If you feel that, hey, it takes a while, I don't want to do it. No, it don't take long at all. And remember.
Do you want to do this or you
want to? Oh, that's fine. Okay. And actually, I'm going to add my steak on there, but since I had a little more peppers than I thought I had, so I'm just going to add the steak in here.
You sautéing the steak up in the pan.
Exactly. Yeah. Okay.
And need your olive oil again.
Yeah, I can remember when I was a kid, my mother making pepper steak. I mean, my mother was the best cook. I mean, she could make the best pepper steak. I mean, ever. I mean, we used to go to the Chinese restaurant, then one week she'll cook pepper steak. But the Chinese did not compare to her pepper steak. I mean, I love her pepper steak. She was she was very good at cooking pepper steak. As a matter of fact, actually, Tori, she's good at cooking pepper steak, too. I mean,
yeah.
Actually, no, we can switch sides, and she's doing just as good a job as I would.
Yeah. The kids like pepper steak, so I had to kind of learn that one.
Right now, what's going on, there's a lot of people, they're watching the cook shows, they start putting their own Chinese food, Mexican food, they start to cook their own Italian food, so if you really want to learn how to cook certain things, or you just click on a food channel and they'll show you anything you want to learn.
Yep. So, veggies are getting done,
so I'm doing over here, just a little oil for the steak, until that get hot. Okay, so what I want to do is, I'm going to add here my steak seasoning, my Montreal steak seasoning to my vegetables. Okay, I'm not going to put the pepper in until last. Okay, here you go. Like I said, like I told you before, what I'm doing, I'm going to add two cups of beef base. And after I add 2 cups of beef base, I'll probably add another 2 cups of regular water. Okay. So this is like a real simple dish. Like anyone can do it. And here's the 2 cups of beef base.
Okay.
Okay, Tracy, you can add me a 2 more cups of water.
Sure.
Okay. And actually, that if you fill this, fill that cup up, it's actually 2 cups.
See? The beef base is already in there, so all I gotta do is just add the regular water. I can remember. I'm always remembering stuff. Trust me.
It's good that you can remember.
Yeah,
you start forgetting everything.
I don't know. Another 4 or 5 more years, you know.
Don't speak it.
No, I'm not speaking it. I'm just saying, hey, you never know.
Don't speak it.
And you have the steak. Okay. And I know this. Steak is so expensive nowadays.
So what cut did you buy?
There was a sirloin steak.
Sirloin?
Yeah, sirloin steak. Yeah. No, well, I think I'm gonna put another cup of water. You can give me 1 more cup, okay?
Alright.
And you let your steak cook. Okay, this is real simple, folks. Anyone can do it. Not her.
So you add your beef base in there, some water.
Yeah.
And did you have your soy sauce? No,
you don't have soy sauce until later. Like, so you want to make sure that you get your gravy going, steak in. Like I said, if so happens, the steaks are expensive these days. So if you buy a cheaper steak, what you need to do is, if once you put it in your sauce, just let the sauce boil a little while, and it'll tenderize itself. If you can't really afford the $12 pound steak, so it'll tenderize itself. Okay, this is a lot of steak here.
Yeah.
Wow.
And the kids won't even be here to eat it.
Exactly. They're going out to dinner.
It's their friend's birthday.
Yeah, going out to dinner, it's a good dinner. Turn this off a little bit. Okay. If you want to, Tori, just give me a pinch more of some steak seasoning over there. I'm gonna add just a little bit. Just maybe half a teaspoon. Add a little more. I love steak seasoning, Montreal steak seasoning, because it really gives it a good flavor. As you can see.
Is that enough?
Yeah, it's a little too much, but that's okay. I'm just gonna add just a little bit. Just add a little more Montreal seasoning, just a little bit.
You're
not
gonna add it to your steak?
No, not the steak. I'll have to add the steak because it's already in this one. Great. See? The steak is kicking really good. See what I'm gonna see this juice in here? I'm gonna use this. It's going right in here, okay? You want all that flavor. That's all flavor. That's the steak. That's steak
the flavor.
Steak flavor.
You want the flavor?
Yeah, I want the steak flavor.
You like want the juice? So, funny story. One time the kids wanted pepper steak, but we didn't have any steak, and so we had some pork chops. So Art made pepper steak with the pork chops, and so he let the kids know. So they was eating it. They was like, "It's good." Did they say it tastes different?
No, they didn't say it at all. They were like, "Oh, wow, this
just
is really good."
Good. He said, "Oh, y'all like that pepper poke."
I didn't have
y'all like that pepper poke, right. Huh? And they was talking about like, what is pepper poke?
No, we didn't have any steak, so they
right.
We hungry. We want to eat right now. I didn't have any steak, so I know, but I had the pork chop, so I would have to slice that pork chop really thin. I did exactly what I'm doing right here.
Yeah.
And I mixed it up, fed it to them. They're like, oh, this is so good.
And we had pepper poke.
That's right. I said, you enjoying that pepper poke? No, but if I had told them that it was pork chop or a pork, they would have had a total meltdown. So sometimes when you're feeding children, you just can't tell them everything. If you go to tell them everything that you do, they're going to complain. They just say, fix it up, give it to them. Because if you tell them what you're cooking before you cook it, they're going to complain. If you just go ahead and cook it and tell them afterwards, then everything is fine.
That's right.
It's an art to that. You know, after having all these children, this is how you learn lessons. This is going here.
All right, so now we're adding the steak, liquid juice. All right.
Oh yeah, see, like don't take long for this. And you gotta see how simple it is, okay? Let me turn this off.
And it's a little loose now, but once you add your roux, it's gonna thicken up into a nice gravy.
Yeah. Oh yeah, see. It's beautiful.
And that's like I say, I don't like my vegetables to get really, really soft. No, I like a little crunch to it. Now, to me, I like that natural vegetable taste. Okay. Now, add my little roux. Thicken it up a little bit. And Tori, hand me my whip right next to you. Little roux. So you want to start off just a little. Then you can always thicken it back up. You can always loosen it, but you do it too thick, you're gonna mess yourself up.
Just add a little at a time.
Yeah, a little roux at a time. Now see how it's thickening up.
It's thickening quickly.
Look at that. Oh yeah.
So let it whip.
Oh yeah, see how they are. Oh yeah. So you can always add a little more. Oh yeah, it's coming along real good. See, when you make your roux is real simple.
Yeah.
All you have to add maybe a stick of butter. And thicken it up, add some flour and thicken it up, and you fine. Oops.
Oh, wow.
That happens.
It's so pretty.
Now, for you guys to miss that gumbo episode, and you like the authentic gumbo, you gotta watch that episode. That gumbo was so delicious. You know, Tori really wasn't crazy about it, but you know she enjoyed it a little bit. Now y'all see how thickened up a little bit, thickened up.
Good.
Yeah, right. You should have seen her face. Let's tell the truth. Let's be honest. She tried it. You know, she's not an authentic gumbo. She like the gumbo that northern. She like that northern gumbo. That the gumbo that is not authentic.
Give me the fake gumbo.
Yeah, she wants fake gumbo. Okay, folks. I'm thickening up. See. And now I'm going to add my
soy sauce.
You know, like I said, I just got maybe a quarter of a cup put in there like that.
Yeah, that gives it that down. Color, too.
Color and to give it that flavor.
Now remember, guys, soy sauce has sodium. So you don't want to add a bunch of salt to your stuff, and then you put that soy sauce in, you've got a salty mess.
Sure, also.
Ain't that right?
Yep. Hey, thank you, honey. You give me a couple of bowls or plates, spoons, and I'll place a couple up and you go from there.
All right.
Like I say, normally I like the summer, but since we're doing a show, I'm just going to just put it right on the plate.
All right.
There, ready? Okay, let's get this out over here. Okay. Like I say, pepper steak. I really can't tell you the first time I tried pepper steak. I'm pretty sure I had to be maybe 7 to 8 years old. My mom cooked for the first time. It was so delicious. I've been liking pepper steak ever since. And bless her soul. My mom was a excellent cook. I mean, she can cook some soul food. Oh my God. I think I'm a good soul food cook, but my mom, oh my goodness, she's excellent soul food. Okay, honey, you give me some silverware and I'll plate this stuff up for you. Like I said, I cut this down a little more. Like I say, normally, you can let the summer and your steak can get, a little more tender. But since we're doing the show, I'm not gonna really let it simmer as long. Okay. Okay, you can actually, if you want to, just give me that chili scooper.
Oh, all my stuff is up in the cabinet.
Okay.
Or I can't barely.
Okay, I get it. I'm gonna do this. Okay, just stir this like this. No, keep it going, and I grab it.
Oh yeah, that's a nice creamy gravy. The color is absolutely perfect. The peppers and the onions have the right consistency.
Okay.
Not mushy, but nice and a nice soft firm. Awesome. Okay.
Actually tastes like pepper steak.
And the And the steak is tender.
Mm-hmm.
The bell peppers is perfect.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Texture, flavor, on point.
It's hot.
Yeah.
So guys, thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Have a good one.
Bye-bye.
Bye guys.